Hello everyone and welcome to this last video session on the environmental chemistry. So for today we are going to take a look into the last two remaining concepts such as the water pollution and the soil pollution and the different types. Okay, so let us begin with the first one, and that is going to be the water pollution. Now, water pollution is nothing more than the addition of any foreign substances into the water bodies, making it harmful for the animals, for the marine life, for the plants, making it unfit for drinking or for any domestic or industrial use. Such a condition, we call it as the water pollution. So quite straightforward, that is, whenever we have any water bodies, and in these particular water bodies are going to be inserted with the foreign substances. Okay, so these particular foreign substances are going to see that these water bodies are going to be harmful because of the presence of these foreign substances. So, as a result of which, this water body becomes harmful for. It becomes harmful for the animals, for the aquatic life, for the plants. Okay, so it also becomes unfit for drinking, domestic use, or any industrial uses. Apart from this, when you look at this particular water, it is becoming unfit for the purpose it was intended to use for. Okay, so therefore, for animal lives, I will just continue over here, for the animal lives, for the plants, okay, for the marine life, etc. So it becomes because of these particular foreign substances. And further, because of these particular foreign substances, this water cannot be used for the purpose it was intended to use for. Okay, so therefore, because of these foreign substances, these water bodies will be having a foul odor. Okay. It will be having a foul odor. Further, when we look at these particular water, it will be having a particular bad taste, or you can say as an offensive taste. Furthermore, when you take a look at these particular water, it will be having an unpleasant color. Now, usually the unpleasant color is because of the oily substances or the greasy type of substances, or sometimes because of the weeds which are growing in the water bodies. Okay, so because of these, the color changes, offensive taste and the foul odor, which makes it unfit. It becomes, these particular water bodies completely become unfit. It becomes unfit for, of course, domestic purpose, for industrial use. Alright, and finally, it becomes unfit for drinking purpose. Okay, so this entire thing we classify under the water pollution. Now, there are different types of water pollution depending upon the source of water. So, let's start with the first source of water, and that is going to be the groundwater pollution. Okay, now whenever it rains, okay, the water that falls on the surface of earth, it passes through an n number of earthly materials. It passes through the surface of earth. Okay, so if we consider this as the surface of earth, and whatever the water that falls on the surface of earth, it goes through a number of earthly materials. When it undergoes through a number of earthly materials, this water usually gets purified. And this purified water, at last, it reaches to the ground table. or you can also call it as the ground water table. Okay, so this is a source, this is the entire source over here. Now, due to this, whatever the water that we get over here at the end, this water is completely purified by the help of earthly materials. Now, that is a region, that is a particular thing where you have a very good source of pure water. And because of this particular fact, in rural areas, they have wells or they use the water from the natural springs. So, we have two things over here. That is, because of the well or because of the natural spring. Okay, the water is usually used from these particular sources for the domestic purposes or for any particular agricultural uses. Now, in the recent days, what has happened is because of the domestic waste, that is because of the domestic waste, because of the fertilizers, okay, because of the industrial effluents which are disposed on earth. As the water passes through these, the soluble impurities dissolve into water. As the soluble impurities dissolve into water, it will pass through these and it will reach the groundwater source. Now, because of this, the groundwater source is getting polluted. So, our first point was about the groundwater pollution. So, the groundwater pollution is naturally because of the different types, that is the domestic waste, because of the fertilizers, pesticides, fungicides, because of its industrial effluents, okay, which are directly disposed on the surface of earth or on the soil. When it comes into contact with water, the water is going to dissolve them. As it dissolves them, it goes directly into the groundwater table where it pollutes the entire pure source. Okay, so this was our first point of discussion. The second point of the discussion is that is the river water. Now, when we take a look into the maximum river water, okay. Now here, this is one of the very good source that actually is an open source. Okay. Now whether it is a river water, whether it is the sea water, okay, any open water bodies, try to understand, any open water body, okay, it is directly in contact with the atmospheric gases. The atmospheric gases such as H2S, hydrogen sulfide, okay, we have carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, we have sulfur dioxide, etc. Now, these particular gases, of course, you can also go with the nitrogen oxides. Now, here, these particular gases are directly in contact with the surface of water. Okay, so as they are in contact with the surface of water, these particular gases get easily dissolved into water. Okay, so this is one reason as why these open water bodies get polluted. On the other hand, when you take into look into the other points, it is because of again industrial use. Most of the industries are located on the bank of the rivers. They directly surpass, they just pass all the effluents, industrial waste, into these water bodies. Agricultural waste, they are dumped. Domestic wastes, they are dumped. Sediments, they are passed into water bodies and hence making the good resources of water polluted. Okay, now when we take a look into the last one, that is the seawater pollutions. Now, usually these seawater pollutions occur because of the oil. Okay, now when they try to extract the oil from the bed of the oceans, ocean beds, what happens there is sometimes there is a leakage in oil pipes. Sometimes there is an accident while carrying these oils across. Okay, so the oil is spilled. The oil tankers are spilled. So therefore, algae is one of the major reasons why the water bodies, sea water bodies, gets polluted. Further, when we take a look into the nuclear wastes, okay, so the nuclear wastes are also dumped in the same seas. Okay, so the nuclear waste, industrial wastes, all of these wastes are dumped into the seawater. Apart from this, an alarming issue is about the plastics. Okay, the plastics which are directly disposed into the seas, oceans, making the sources of water quite polluted. Correct. So this was all about the water pollutions. So let's take a look into the next category, and that is going to be the BOD and COD. So coming towards the next concept, and that is of the BOD and COD. Okay, now what exactly it is, we'll try to understand it through a small figure. Now let's consider that I have a particular vessel or a container, and let's say this container can hold up to 1 liter. It can hold up to 1 liter of water. And let us say that whatever the water that I'm going to take over here, it is contaminated by waste. So therefore, we are going to take over here the waste water, or you can also call it as the polluted water. It's fine. Okay. Now, in this particular polluted water, of course, there are going to be microorganisms. Correct. Now, the amount of oxygen, okay, the amount of oxygen in milliliters, that is going to be used by the anaerobic bacteria. Who's going to use them? It's going to be used by anaerobic. By the anaerobic bacteria. Okay, so when these anaerobic bacteria decompose these waste, when they decompose the waste, okay, when they decompose the waste, they require oxygen. So how much amount of the oxygen that has been utilized by the anaerobic bacteria in order to decompose the waste present in 1 liter of water at 20 degrees Celsius for 5 days. Okay, so this becomes a little bit lengthier definition. So in short, biochemical oxygen demand, this is what it's called as BOD, biochemical oxygen demand. Okay, so this particular biochemical oxygen demand is nothing more than how much amount of oxygen that has been utilized or consumed by the anaerobic bacteria to decompose the waste which is present in 1 liter of water at 20 degrees Celsius for 5 days. And that is called as the BOD. This particular section is called as the BOD, biochemical oxygen demand. Now, it becomes very tiresome. It is going to consume a lot of time in order to calculate this, correct, for 5 days. Now, instead of that, they have an alternative, and the alternative is to go with the COD. Okay, so COD, it is the chemical oxygen demand. Now it is quite simple as how much amount of oxygen that is going to react with the substances other than the organic wastes. Okay, so chemical oxygen demand is the amount of oxygen, okay, that reacts with substances other than the chemical, other than the organic waste. And that particular thing, we call it as oxygen demand. Okay, now let's try to understand how the COD or the BOD is going to help us in order to understand the purity of water. Okay, so first thing, let's discuss about COD. When we take a pure water, okay, so when we take a pure water, its COD is nearby 5. Okay, so it's nearby 5 ppm parts per million. Okay, so lower the COD, higher its purity. That means it do not require more amount of oxygen in order to decompose anything. Correct. So in pure water, there is no waste. As there is no waste, there is no point in decomposing it. As there is no point in decomposing it, that means the oxygen requirement is very less. Okay, so that is how it goes for the pure water. So for the pure water, it is going to be the 5 ppm. Now, when you take impure water, impure or highly polluted water, okay, it is going to be 17 ppm. Okay, now when you take a look into water from sewage treatment plants, from the particular plants which treats wastes. Okay, so when we take a look there, so from the sewage treatment plants, okay, the municipal waste. So when we take a look at these particular wastes, you can see it around 400 ppm. Okay, so 400 parts per million requirement of oxygen. So highly, you can say, as a wasteful water. Correct. Now, when you take a look into the BOD, BOD also functions in the same way. That is, how much amount of oxygen is required by the anaerobic bacteria there. So, for the pure water, you can see the BOD value from 0 to 3. Right? Now, if you have a particular BOD of 5 ppm, okay, so the purity is doubtful. And if you see 20 ppm, okay, so here this water is completely unacceptable. Okay, we cannot accept this particular water. And when you see untreated sewage water, okay, it has a whopping value of 10,000 ppm. Okay, so higher the ppm values, higher the BOD or COD values, you can say higher is the impurity of that water. Correct. So this ends with respect to the water pollution and how to determine the purity of the water. Okay, so let's start with the next section, and that is going to be the soil pollutions. Coming towards the final point, and that is going to be the soil pollutions. So the soil pollution, when we take a look at it, the first point that arises is this soil pollution. Why does it occur? It occurs because of the one major reason. And that one major reason is the solid waste. Okay, now these are solid wastes. It can be right from the agriculture waste, it can be the industrial wastes, correct? It can be the waste from the cities like the garbage, glass pieces, tin cans, etc. All of these particular solid wastes end up mixing and just not producing poisonous or toxic gases. They also, when they mix,
They give rise to the breeding grounds. The breeding grounds for mosquitoes and for the bacteria. Okay, so this particular solid waste, the mixing, the gathering of all these particular solid waste from the different types of sources, they end up giving rise to poisonous or toxic gases. They release it into the atmosphere. They work as the breeding grounds for mosquitoes, for the bacteria, and which usually end up giving rise to different types of diseases. Okay, so now we need to understand that what are the different sources from which we are going to get these solid wastes. So the solid wastes, the first and foremost what it comes to our mind is the industrial waste. Okay, so now in order for an industry to work, it requires a raw material. Whatever the raw material they import, okay, 50% of these raw materials, almost 50% of these raw materials end up as wastes after production. Okay, so 50% of these after production, whatever the raw materials that they import, it goes out as a waste. But this time, this wastes are also going to have toxic chemicals. Disastrous chemicals are present along with these particular wastes. Now what they do is, they take these particular wastes, right, and they straightly dump it in rivers or the soil nearby. This is what the industries do. They do not treat the wastes. If the particular waste is treated properly and if these particular toxic chemicals are going to be separated by different separating techniques, then these particular things, even if they are dumped in a soil, they can be decomposed. Okay, now the problem with these chemicals which they have in this waste is that these chemicals are non-biodegradable. Now that is a problem. Okay, because they are non-biodegradable, they directly affect the environment. And this is how the entire thing works here. Okay, and if they would have treated these chemicals, there would be no problem of biodegrading it. There would be no problem of decomposing these particular raw materials. Okay, so our first point that we need to understand is the source of this particular solid waste which is causing the soil pollution is right from the industrial wastes. The second point that we need to understand is this solid waste are coming right from the urban areas. Okay, so what we call them as the urban wastes. Daily, an unmanageable amount of solid waste is being produced. And these particular solid waste have to be treated. These solid waste contain a lot of plastic material. They contain a lot amount of garbages. They contain the glass pieces. They contain the vegetable or the different types of food wastes. Okay. So, n number of wastes are being produced in the urban city areas, and this amount is highly unmanageable. Okay, so we need to treat that particular amount. And yes, again, these particular things are again straightly dumped in soils or in nearby areas. Okay, now due to this again, it gives rise to a number of polluting toxic gases. Okay, so this was a point number two. The point number three is right from the agriculture. that is the agriculture wastes. Now what happens in the agriculture waste is that the farmers tend to use the fertilizers, correct? They also use different types of fungicides, pesticides. Now these particular things, of course, they may increase the yield. Okay, so all these particular fertilizers or your fungicides, okay, now they may increase the yield, but what happens is, on the other hand, it causes a problem directly to the soil. It increases the yield but directly pollutes the soil. Okay, so but they are going to pollute the soil. Now there are certain pesticides such as DDT or the gametes. Okay, now it's gametes. Now what happens is, whether it is DDT or whether it is gametes, now these particular things are these are non-biodegradable. As these are non-biodegradable, they directly enter into the food chain through different animals. Okay, now again, all of this is going to cause problem for the soil, soil pollutions. Final one, the most dangerous one, and that is the nuclear waste. Now what happens is, whenever they test nuclear power plants, okay, nuclear testings have been done by the help of the different nuclear devices, they end up giving the nuclear dust. Okay, sometimes nuclear dust which settles back on the soil, pollutes the soil. Sometimes nuclear waste, what they have, they directly dump it into the soil. Now these nuclear waste have been causing a direct problem at a genetic level. They cause mutations at the genetic level, due to which it is very, very, very harmful. Now, in order to see that these particular wastes, that is the nuclear waste, have to be packed in a thick concrete block or thick steel blocks, okay, and they have to be buried. They have to be buried. They have to be buried right into the salt mines, okay, or they have to be buried under the sea surface. Okay, so this is how we need to treat the nuclear wastes. Now I hope you people have understood about the different types of the soil pollution. And therefore, it ends our chapter at this point. Do take care. Please do study well. If there is any problem, please do feel free to contact us.